Hello and welcome back. My name is Jess Marion, and today I'm going to begin the process of building your events matrix. Now, the reason why we're taking so much time to focus on the preliminary work is that it's absolutely vital to a successful DTI. And as you go through the DTI experiences a little bit later on in this program, your unconscious mind will have already succeeded in building a strong, positive, and transformative representation of your particular model. So for today, we're going to focus on how you can begin to lay the foundations in the unconscious mind for a successful DTI. And the primary way we do this is by having as many reference experiences of the model as possible. Now, some of you may be very fortunate in that you have direct access to your model. Maybe there's somebody you know, somebody you can go spend time with. And that is fantastic. From today into tomorrow and into the future as a part of your modeling project, go spend time with them. Talk to them. Live your normal life and trust that your unconscious mind is picking up a tremendous amount of information about the model. Now, for those of you who don't have direct access to your model, maybe it's someone who no longer lives, or it's somebody famous, or it's somebody from literature, now's your opportunity to build a structure that your unconscious mind can follow. And to do this, we encourage you to find representations of your model in a number of different sources. The first and the most powerful source of information about your model is through video. So search on YouTube. If you have any film footage of your model, go ahead and immerse yourself in it. Watch it, and we're not going to ask you today to do anything with it beyond just experience it, because you're seeding the unconscious mind for a powerful experience. So video is going to be the next most powerful source of information for the DTI. After that is going to be recordings, audio recordings. So any tapes, any CDs, anything with voice of the model. This is going to be incredibly powerful as well. After that, you can find source information about the model from biographies and autobiographies. Autobiographies in particular will give you a tremendous amount of information about some of the unconscious drives and programs that the model is acting upon. Now, we have this structured in terms of like best to maybe the least desirable, in that we start with live contact, down to video, down to audio, down to written text. And there is a very specific reason for this in terms of how your neurology is designed. We don't have time to go too much into it here. However, if you'd like to dive into the neuroscientific aspects of deep trance identification, feel free to check out our book, Deep Trance Identification, by Sean Carson, Jess Marion, and John Overdurf, available at Amazon. And there will probably be a link somewhere on this screen for you to click to find it. Now, the last place that you'll find a breadth of information is the internet. The internet may have videos and audios and biographies, but if you look at like Wikipedia or any of these more general and broad sources, they tend to have a very descriptive bibliography, and it will give you a roadmap to find as much information as possible about your model. Now, tomorrow, we're going to go ahead and refine this. So for today, just immerse yourself in anything and everything you can find about your model. And in our next video, I'm going to show you exactly how to refine this so that it becomes a usable structure for your deep trance identification experience. But for now, that's it. Have a wonderful day, and I look forward to speaking with you tomorrow.